why don't you make a full album in German? And we were like, we don't know.
Hey everyone, welcome to the channel. I am Belgian Jasper. If this is your first time on the channel, hit subscribe right now. German metalcore legends CALIBAN are back with a new extended EP called Zeitgeister. On that album, they have reworked some of their classic songs into new, modern and German songs. On top of that, we know that another album is coming as well to talk about all these things and more. I sat down with guitar player Marc. Marc, thank you so much for your time today. Just a few days until the new release. Exciting, but you've seen it all. You've been in this band for quite some time. We'll come back to that later. You've seen everything happen already over the years, but this is still a very special or a different kind of release. Does that make you still, even with all that experience, very excited about what's going to come out later this week? Or are we at the spot where, like, you know, whatever happens, happens? I've seen it all.
Yeah. I'm always somehow excited. But on the other hand, whatever happens, happens, because it's still like in the beginning. We make the music we want to do for ourselves. And if other people like it, even better. But so, of course, you don't want everyone to hate it, obviously. But I'm always very excited what people think, and that didn't change. But it's not different. I mean, it is a little different because it's kind of like a special release. You know, it was that was actually supposed to be like let's call it an add-on to the original album, which is delayed. Usual album was supposed to come out in October, and then we delayed it because we can't tour and all this crap what happens right now. And but we kept the release of the special as it is. To not delay that as well. It's so long ago that we did something, so let's put that out anyways, you know. And it's just exciting to see how, like, let's say international fans react in it, because it's like German, you know. I mean, I can assure you, and if some people are afraid of it or something or worried, the next album will be English. The full album with 12 tracks will be English again, as always.
For those that are watching this interview that don't really know what we're talking about, the album that is being released right now is, except for one new original song, Nichts, it's a selection of older songs that you guys have reworked and now made into a German version, if you will. I've seen some people post responses saying that, doesn't matter if you can't understand shit when everything just sounds perfect. Yeah. So I guess that's a good thing. What was the most difficult thing for you guys to rework the songs and create lyrics that are relevant and that sound good in German, or just figuring out which of the songs out of that massive back catalog would be the ones?
Somehow both. It was, I can tell you, it was really more difficult to write this than a normal album, because we have tried many things in the whole process, because we are also like different opinions inside the band how to approach all this. For example, one guy in the band said it would be cool to have like a live session in the studio record, and we just play the songs like they were. And I was like, nah, it's like, you know, the people heard the songs the way they were in the past, you know. They have a relevance in that time, and the charisma of the recording at the time they were released. If you just with modern technology record like a 16-year-old song, it's not living up to it somehow, you know. It's not being creative for me, you know. Just to throw out the old song, just put German lyrics on, fine, done, you know. That is to me it would have been boring. And then we wanted somehow to rework the songs and have a little hint here and there that people from the past acknowledge, ah, that is from this song, this is this song, but also don't get the feeling, ah, that I heard that long ago, that is boring, because I heard that already, so it's something new. Mm-hmm. And for younger fans to really have like an experience that is like a new song for them, because it's transformed into the music we do somehow now.
Yeah.
And then we decided to not just translate the lyrics, because that didn't work at all. We tried, but it didn't work at all, because the phrases are much longer, much shorter. The words sound stupid in German or whatever, you know. And then that's why we had so many, we tried so many things until we were where we are. And at the very end, we said, okay, we have like a plan. Now we just take bits and pieces of songs we like and make them into something new, and you have the topic of the lyrics, and write new lyrics related to that topic, which are somehow, sometimes some words are maybe the same, just translated, but in general they have the same meaning, but a complete new version of the lyric, because it didn't work at all. So to get to that point was a pretty long process, you know, and to find out how that would be the best way. And and when you write a new song, you just write a new song, put lyrics on, fine, done, you know. There's nothing you have to really worry about, you know, just that it's a good song, you know. That was this time a bit more difficult.
I think a lot of people really discovered the band through your split series with Heaven Shall Burn. A lot of people have been talking already since this new album, Zeitgeister, has been announced, like, oh, they're doing an album in German, and Heaven Shall Burn has played songs in German before as well. Maybe it's time for the split program part three. I know that you guys are friendly with Heaven Shall Burn, but both of you bands, obviously, after those two split EPs, you both blew up quite a lot. Any hopes or plans of doing a part three of that series?
Yeah, that is somehow like a running gag already, because so many people are asking and stuff like that. And I actually think what we talked about at some point is that if we do that, we always wanted to do that, you know. And then either they were busy, we were busy, something. And then we said, okay, when both bands decide now it's time to go away, call it quits, then we do like a goodbye, a goodbye split city part three, like as a farewell thing somehow. So that might happen. So at some point, maybe. So that was that's what Mike and me were, for example, and also Andy, our singer, were talking about. We said, okay, if we do that, I mean, we still want to do that, but let's do that something special, like as a farewell or something.
Yeah. All right. Well, then I'll keep my fingers crossed that we don't see that split. Back to the album. Is it to some extent also, maybe even more for Andy or Andreas than anybody else in the group, liberating to express yourself in German versus before always in English?
Andy was always pretty much against all that German thing.
Okay.
Like, we discovered that he sounds good in German when we did the Rammstein cover song.
Yeah.
And he was, before, we wanted always to have some German stuff, and he was like, I sound stupid in German, I don't want, and stuff like that. And then we did that cover track. He's like, what are you talking about? Sounds great. You know, and since that day, we always had like this special song in German on the album, the past couple albums. And then this idea grew to have like some kind of special thing in German. And then the idea was actually born. We had a radio interview in Berlin, and the guy actually asked, why don't you make a full album in German? And we were like, we don't know. Would be. And then somehow, and then he said, do some special, that would be cool, because our listeners here, they are the audience, they like the German songs when we play them. We say, and then we actually then it developed into the idea, you know.
Yeah.
Now I think now Andy's completely fine and likes it in German, you know. Of course, his pronunciation is much easier for him, and expressing
himself is easier for him,
you know. And yeah, I think he enjoys it.
As per usual, we get, you know, the two sides where both the band is looking very critically at society, but also very introspective as well. These are sentiments that everybody, no matter who you are, where you come from, much more than ever in your life with the pandemic, you've been faced with. People had to deal with mental health issues, with anxiety that they never had to deal with before, maybe not as profound. Do you, even regardless of the fact that certain lyrics are, well, all the lyrics are now in German, do you see fans react differently than previous releases? Do you get people say that they relate to the songs, even if they don't always understand the lyrics without translating them?
Yeah, especially with the first one, with the first single, Intoleranz. Because we felt that was a really necessary thing to say nowadays, how people act and react and behave and stuff like that. And when we put that out, we got a lot of feedback that they thought also that it's like a important thing to say. Yeah, and as for nichts, for example, Andy is kind of like, let's call it sensitive to this kind of subject somehow. He also said like, oh, it's so hard, such a hard time for me. And then he's like easily drowning a little bit into that. And we had to also take care and say, oh, come on, you know, head up somehow, you know, get your heads up. But, also fans contact us, you know, like during this time, and it's really, really hard to not say the wrong things, and you obviously give them the professional numbers to call for help or something, because people know that we always had this kind of lyrics, and then we try to, I don't know, to express ourselves, especially Andy, with these kind of things. And they were contacting us, and oh, I feel so bad, and then could you help me with this and this? And you don't want to say the wrong things. It's a really hard time right now, you know? Yeah. And so we actually really saw that it is important to say a couple things. And we always had this kind of thing that people contacted us and said, your music helped us through difficult times, or helped me through because my father died, or something, you know, always something very personal. And so we thought also that we try to put some lyrics into the new EP, which are maybe also helping people now a little bit, you know. And of course, when they come and contact us, we give them the professional numbers to call, because, you know, you don't want to get someone hurt or something, or say the wrong things, because we are not professionals, obviously. But we always had we always felt that we have the need to say a few things like this and do something. It's for us very important.
There's been a few lineup changes at CALIBAN, but in the grand scheme of things, CALIBAN has been a very stable band. I think for the last,
yeah, I think you could 14, call that. I think
16 years.
Yeah, since 2004, I think. Yeah.
Yeah. What, especially when you're dealing with a lot of these personal and heavy subjects, that can often lead to clashes and tense situations. How have you guys kept that healthy lineup? Like, what's the secret within CALIBAN?
First off, we are, I don't want to like destroy someone's illusion or something, but it's, we are not a group of five best friends who hang out every day, you know, like, because everybody knows life, friends change. We of course are friends, I don't want to say that. But it's not like that we are the best five friends in the world and always hang out together, do everything together, go to movies, do everything together, go to Hollywood. You know what I mean? You know, mm-hmm. Of course we go to movies together sometimes. You know, this one goes with him, he goes with him. But, you know, I think we would have had a lot more arguments if we would hang out every day for 20 years. And I think that is something which kept it somehow healthy and, you know, don't piss each other off too much.
Given that a new album is gonna come out, or the next regular, let's call it, album, you said, like, hey, don't worry, it's gonna be in English, it's gonna be back to what we were used to with Caliban. Should we then kind of consider Zeitgeister as the 25th anniversary special greatest hits album in a way? Like, because depending on how you'd count, either next year or the year after is 25 year anniversary of the band.
It wasn't a plan. You can see it as it is, but we are usually a band which doesn't really stick to anniversaries too much, you know, like I didn't even notice that it's an anniversary until I got the first interviews and they were like, oh, you have anniversary soon. Oh, is it? You know, we don't really think too much about it. And but you can say as it is a special, and as it's like re-recorded old stuff or rearranged, not re-recorded old stuff, you could see it as a special for the anniversary.
I mean, the reaction so far seemed to be very positive.
I was surprised. I expected different feedback somehow. I mean, I didn't expect it to be bad, but I thought actually that is actually funny. I expected that people from outside of Germany, Austria, Switzerland are saying, the new album is now German. I wait for the English one, you know, like, because we are not Rammstein. We didn't start off in German and everybody got to know us in German. So it's for them, they got used to English and now we switched to German, you know. So I thought that more people from outside of our area here would think, it's German, it's not my thing. Actually, the most people who criticize that it's German are the Germans. There are, of course, a lot of people from Germany say, oh, I love that because I always like your German special song.
Right.
And now full album German, that's awesome. But there's a little percentage which is the percentage from mother language German. The negative feedback is bigger than from outside of that. I was actually surprised about that. Oh, they were always English. Why they stick to German now? We have other bands for that, you know. It's like, I didn't expect that, you know, like,
interesting. Now, if the reaction stays so positive, does that mean that you might have to push out your other album a little bit more and that people will hope to see you tour Zeitgeister? Or are you guys like, no, we're on the road to the new release and that's what's the priority?
We don't know how soon that is going to be possible, because we want to definitely do a tour with the new album. You know, like I said, the instrumental part is done and they're finishing up the vocal recording this week, I think. And then I get everything to mix it here. I'm sitting in my studio. And there's definitely going to be some live special thing happening around Zeitgeister when it's possible.
Yeah.
We thought about that, we maybe do like a short run, short tour, like a week or 10 days, where we play, for example, the entire Zeitgeister live, you know, also all other German songs we had before.
Okay.
That is like a special tour with just the German tracks, you know, like, that was actually the plan. And it was, like, it all moved around. We were supposed to tour last year in October, November with the new album, and then in April release this kind of special and have like special sets on festivals, special shows in between festivals, like just this German kind of thing, you know, that moved around now a bit. But there will be something, definitely. We will play a lot of this Zeitgeister stuff live. The new album changed a bit because of Zeitgeister. That is actually funny, because it was supposed to be different. because we stopped working on the new album because we wanted to finish Zeitgeister, because we knew, okay, the new album is going to be delayed, so let's finish the EP first. And then we went back to writing the album and took some part of the old school stuff back with us, because we were listening so much to it, to the new album as well. So that is actually a funny coincidence and I think a pretty cool side effect to it somehow.
Marc, I want to thank you very much for your time today and for all your flexibility. Thank you for answering all my questions. Looking forward to the release first of Zeitgeister now on Friday. And can't wait for the new album then as well in maybe those 8-9 months to see. And hopefully we get to see you on the road well before that, supporting
Zeitgeister. I hope in Canada.
Again, I definitely hope that you guys come to Toronto when we've... Once I guess both Germany and Canada have a few more vaccines available, so that everybody can come enjoy shows again in a safe way. Thank you so much for your time. I appreciate it, and I look forward to the new release.
Thank you.
You're awesome for watching this video. Click right here to see more content like it and subscribe to the channel.